Assalamu alaikum. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Rabishrahli sadri wa yassirli amri wa halul uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Rabbi zidni ilma. Okay dear children, how are you? How is everyone? Are you stressed out or are you enjoying your learning? Don't get stressed out at all. Inshallah, you will be able to manage. Today we are going to discuss one more paper, that is paper 2. And you may have seen the other videos that are dealing with other papers also. If you haven't, please do watch and comment so that I will be able to know what else you want to prepare, or you want me to discuss with you for your own learning and your own understanding. Okay. Today we are going to work on 2210 paper 2-3, which is October November paper. Paper name is Algorithms, Programming and Logic. Very first thing that I'm again repeating, you have to answer on the question paper. You will not be given any additional material at all. Instructions, you have to answer all questions, and I suggest that you answer them in a sequence. You have to take a black or a dark blue pen with you, as well as a pencil, in case there is any diagram that you need to draw or any graph that is supposed to be made. You have to write your name, center number, and candidate number in the boxes at the top of each page. Write your answer to each question in the space provided. Do not use an erasable pen or correction fluid. Do not write on any barcode. Please be very cautious. And please, very important thing is, do not carry a calculator at all, because calculators will not be allowed in the examination hall. Paper is of 75 marks, and the number of marks are given at the end of each question. No mark will be awarded for using the brand names. So please do not use it at all. Otherwise, you will not score anything at all. Question number one. Tick one box to show which term is an example of a verification check. Double entry, format check, length check, presence check. So simple. Definitely format check, length check, presence check. They all are examples of validation excellent. So definitely you can score one mark so easily just by ticking double entry check, and you will score one mark. Fine. If you have any queries, then you can watch a validation and verification video also, and so that you can understand that also. Tick one box, question number two. Tick one box to show which library routine returns the remainder of a division. So just again, options are div, mod, random, and round. These four functions are there for you. But by the way, very simple, div and mod. Now, definitely there is no use of random at all and round at all. That is very obvious. So now the competition is between div and mod. So just remember, div is going to give you the quotient and mod is going to give you the remainder. Make a shortcut also for your own memory, because you may get confused. So mod is remainder, MR, so that you're not going to get confused at all. In a second, you have scored one mark once again. Question number three, four descriptions regarding pseudocode and five keywords are shown here. You have to draw a line to each pseudocode description like with the appropriate pseudocode word. And again, remember, there's an instruction, not all pseudocode words are going to be used. So just let's read. Stores data in a file, retrieves data from a file, displays data on a screen, enters data from a keyboard. Now, these are the four descriptions, and the options that are given are output, write, read, open, and input. Now, what you will do, very simple thing is displays data on a screen. This is what we have been doing in flowcharts. This is what we have been doing in pseudocode. So you will simply select output. Enters data from a keyboard, very simple input. I mean, this is done for you and you are relaxed, because these are the two terms that we have been using quite often. So you can actually recall and you'll be able to answer. Stores data in a file. Now, this means that you have to write the data in a file. So definitely that will be write. And by the way, we have also learned the file handling. So you may have learned these terms. And then retrieves data from a file is going to be read. And in this manner, you can very easily understand this whole thing. Fine. So you can easily score 4 out of 4. Give two reasons for storing data in a file. Very simple. Data is stored permanently. Data can be moved to another computer. Now, you can score very easily if you just pay attention to these main concepts. Definitely, why do I store data in a file? Because I want it to be stored permanently. Definitely, maybe I want to transfer the data to another computer. And definitely, someone can write creating a backup copy also. So these all are valid answers. I may need to store the data in the computer so that it can be accessed anywhere else also. So just think here, they want you to understand and answer the basic reason that why do we store data in a file? Simple, very simple. Now, moving on to question number four. Any questions till now? Okay. Question number four. A programmer is writing a data entry program for booking theater seats. The programmer needs the program to accept only whole numbers that are greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to 6. Now you can see it's written in English, but what you can do is here, before you attempt the question, I suggest you that you write down, underline the keyword whole numbers that are greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to 6. You just write down greater than or equal to 1 in a simple way, and less than or equal to 6. So you can actually attempt part B also. This is why I'm suggesting you that attempt in the same manner. Underline the key concepts which you think are important for you. Write them down in something that is going to make your answering a little easier. So you mention it in this manner and you'll be able to answer it accurately. Give the names of two validation checks that are required for this program. So very first thing is greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to 6 means it's the digits. So you will go for the range check. That's wonderful, Ali. And another one is, since we are dealing with accepting the whole numbers only, so it means that I'm going to work on type check. So in this manner, you can actually score very easily by just figuring it out from your memory and writing down the right check names. Now complete this pseudocode to perform your two validation checks using your answers given in A. Now this is what you need to do. Please enter the number of seats you want to book. Input seats is given to you. So what will you do? Definitely you need to ensure that you are going to ensure that right data is entered. So definitely for rain check, what have we learned? Definitely we are going to use a loop. Is a for loop going to be used here? Will it be a good option to use for loop here? No, not at all. That's wonderful, Ali. That's you are able to recall immediately and you are able to answer that for is basically used when you know the number of iterations beforehand. Here we don't know. Maybe the person can enter in the first go. Maybe the person can keep on entering and he is not entering the right value. So that is why the conditional loops are going to be the best option still if there's any confusion. So please do watch the loop structures video so you are going to understand and answer that also. So while seats is less than 1, all seats greater than 6. Now you can see input seats is the value. So here you can simply perform the activity while seats less than 1 or seats greater than 6. That is going to help you with your range check. Or seats is not equal to round seats, 0. So in this manner, you can actually ensure that your value entered is basically the whole number. So in this manner, or seats not equal to round seats, 0 do. Output the same, input the same, and end while. So in this manner, you can easily score 5 out of 5. See, 5 marks. Use of loop for check. Checking for whole number is going to give you 1 more mark. Checking for number greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to 6. Appropriate error or re-input messages and ability to re-input the value. So these are like definitely, although they have written it for you, but you have to write it down in the given space. And you have to rewrite these instructions. Do not leave them. Do not think that you have done the work, so it means that that is okay. You definitely have to rewrite the whole. It's written in this just to make you comprehend that this was already given to you. But you'll have to attempt it in the complete manner. And only then you will be able to score 5 out of 5. Be very cautious. Okay, give one item of test data to use when testing the program. State the reason for your choice of test data. So you can see test data is 7, an example. I mean, just an example. Any student can write any value, and this is abnormal data. Another student can go for the normal data also. Yes, correctly quoted, Ahmed, that maybe you can write down normal values. But by the way, if the normal values are mentioned, what will you go for? Yes, what will you go for? Okay, definitely you are going to go for a value that is in between, like you can say 2, you can th say 3, you can say 4 or 5. So these are going to be the normal values. And another student can write extreme values also. Perfect. Extreme data. So definitely extreme data will be rejected or accepted. Extreme data will be accepted. That's wonderful. So you can, I mean, different students can quote different examples, but they need to remember if they have taken abnormal data, they have to take a value that is abnormal. If they have thought that they need to write down normal, then the value that is they are mentioning should be a normal value. And if they want to work on extreme, then it should be definitely 1 or 6. And again, remember, only one value to be written, please. Do not think that you can write down many values and still you will be able to score. Please be very cautious about it. Okay? Understood, everyone? Any questions? I hope that this is also clear. We have been practicing this validation checks till now, so I hope that that is not a problem for any one of you, isn't it? Now, question number 5. An algorithm has been written in pseudocode to check if a new password is in a list of previously used passwords, old list. Old list is an array. If the password is not found, the new password would be stored at the end of the list to replace this value already stored. Now, this is your whole pseudocode. Output, enter your password, input new password, POSN is equal to 1, found equals to false, repeat. If password equals to old list, POSN a variable, then found equals to true, else POSN equals to POSN plus 1, and if until found and old list POSN is equal to x, 4 x's. If found, then output password has been used before, else input new password accepted, old list POSN equals to new password, end if. Now, this don't get confused at all. Like, this is an array, so you are getting confused. Not at all, beta. You just have to go through this. Now, they are saying identify 3 errors in the pseudocode and suggest corrections. This is your question. First thing, let's see. What will you do is you will first of all move line by line and then see. Output enter your password seems to be correct because there is a message. Input new password and then see, is this correct? Fine, just figure out. Is the same thing used many times? Yes, it means that this is correct. POSN equals to 1, found equals to false, repeat. If password equals to old p list POSN, so old list is your array, password. Now, this seems to be incorrect. Since we have taken input in new password, it means that this is an error and you need to just identify this one right now. Do not attempt it again. And then you have just circled it or whatever, and then work on this. Input should be now. You can see if password is wrong, line number 6, it should have been new password. Now move further. Line number 7, definitely then is correct. Found equals to true. Else, POSN equals to POSN plus 1. Seem to be correct. Line number 10, end if. Again, position very properly. If and then end if. Until found and old list equals to PSN. So this in this situation, the word and is incorrect. It should have been replaced with or. Until found means until the value is found, keep on working, or the old list PSN is matching with this one. See, both conditions have not to be are not supposed to be can say figured it out. You need to work with in this manner. Or any one condition true, it should stop working. Remember, repeat until is a post-condition loop. And here the condition is written later. And both conditions definitely will be matched. And any one condition being true, it will stop the work. Definitely, until found means found. So what's the use of continuing to work, isn't it? Fine. Now, if found, then output password has been used before. Else, input new password accepted. Now, does it seem to be correct? Input new password. Definitely, that's right to your mind. It should have been output, because then you are moving the value of the new password into this position. So this is how you can, don't get confused at all. It's an array, this and that, not at all. You have to be confident with your own learning and then do it this way, fine? Understood? Now, complete this flowchart for the corrected algorithm and 1 mark for data entry messages. Now you can see complete. Now this was here, start and stop were given to you. Now they are asking you to write, to make the password, to make the whole thing. Output enter your new password, input new password. PUSN equals to 1, found equals to false. If new password equals to old list PUSN, yes. Found equals to true, move here. No, PUSN equals to PUSN plus 1. Is found or old list PUSN equals to this? Yes. No is going to move here once again. If found, yes, it will output a message password has been used before. No, output new password accepted. And we are performing this activity. So just you need to be cautious with your own learning of the symbols which are used in your flowcharts, and you will be able to manage very easily. So simple, isn't it? Just pay attention to the same, the whole concept that you are going to ask the person to enter the password, check with the value, are they matching? If they are matching, then found equals to true. If found, or the same thing. Now here, be cautious. Here you have to use the correct, the corrected pseudocode that you have mentioned in the beginning in part A. And this manner, you are going to do it very easily. Not a difficult thing at all. Now, is new password equals to oldest PUSN? Now, yes, it will be moving to this one once again, to the found equals to true, and then otherwise it will be moving on. If found, found equals to true, matching, it will be moving back to this, is found or oldest PUSN equals to this one? No, move back and keep on checking it. Otherwise, if found, then it is going to stop the whole procedure. Clear? Okay. That's wonderful. So inshallah, we are going to meet again for this later part of this paper. So stay tuned so that you are able to know the latest updates on the YouTube channel. Allah Hafiz.